Earlier this year, in July of 2021, a lawsuit was filed by the Department of Fair Employment and Housing against Activision Blizzard against their misconduct of women in the workplace. This entire lawsuit went over pretty much everything under the sun, including harassment, pay disparity, women just being walked all over, and it even got to the point where there was a story recounted of a woman actually taking her own life while on a business trip. I go into way more detail on that original video. If you'd like to see it, I'll put a link in the description below. Let me tell you how this morning began. I jumped onto Twitter to see if there was anything going on in the Call of Duty sphere. I follow a lot of men and women that work at Sledgehammer, Treyarch, and Infinity Ward, and I saw a majority of them saying that they're going to be off of work for 10 days, paid time off. That's pretty damn cool. Thanksgiving's right around the corner. They're going to have time off, and they're looking forward to starting their vacation. That news on its own would be fantastic. Imagine your boss just tells you, hey, guess what? 10 days off, paid time off, just go have fun. Then about an hour and a half to 2 hours later, a huge new post by the Wall Street Journal came out talking about how Bobby Kotick knew about all of the different misconduct happening within Activision and didn't do a single thing. In certain cases, he covered it up and even threatened female employees not to speak about it. This then led many of the employees that just got their 10-day off notice to wonder if this was actually out of good faith and because of all the hard work that they did, or because it's a manipulation tactic from Bobby Kotick. So at this point, you might be wondering what happened. Over the past several months, three journalists from the Wall Street Journal were doing some reporting on the allegations of the misconduct at Activision and what Bobby Kotick knew but didn't do about it. These stories go all the way back to 2006, where one of his assistants complained that Bobby had harassed her, including threatening her in a voicemail to have her killed. And if you thought that sounded pretty wild, they actually confirmed that this happened. An Activision spokeswoman said that Mr. Kotick quickly apologized 16 years ago for the obvious hyperbolic and inappropriate voicemail, and he deeply regrets the exaggeration and tone in his voicemail to this day. But not even a year later, in 2007, he was sued by the flight attendant on a private jet he co-owned. The flight attendant claimed that the plane's pilot had sexually harassed her, and after she complained to the other owner, Bobby Kotick fired her. The defendants denied these allegations, and in a separate action related to legal fees in the case, an arbitrator, citing what he said was sworn testimony, wrote that Bobby told the flight attendant and her attorneys, "I'm going to destroy you." A spokesman for Kotick denied that that ever was said. Then in 2008, on that same exact case a year later, they settled by paying the attendant $200,000. A spokesman for Bobby came out and said that he couldn't have fired her in retaliation for complaining because she never complained directly to him. Now, I don't know if y'all remember this, but back in August of 2021, Activision named Jen O'Neill the first female co-head of the World of Warcraft studio in Blizzard. The very next month, she sent an internal email criticizing the company's top management and recounting her own experiences of harassment. Through this email, Ms. O'Neill went on to explain how she had been harassed early in her career at Activision. She was paid less than her male counterpart at the helm of Blizzard, and she wanted to discuss her resignation. "I have been tokenized, marginalized, and discriminated against," wrote Ms. O'Neill, who is Asian American and gay. She described a party for an Activision development studio she attended with Mr. Kotick around 2007, in which scantily clad women danced on stripper poles. At the same party, a DJ encouraged female attendees to drink more so the men would have a better time, according to another person who was also present. Activision announced on November 2nd that Ms. O'Neill is leaving Blizzard at year end. Ms. O'Neill said in an email statement that she made a decision that was best for her and her family. What's even more mind-boggling to me is this just happened. Like, on the 2nd of November, just a couple of weeks ago, Jen was hired just a few weeks after this lawsuit began in July. And even then, she was still being discriminated against in terms of pay, and that, to me, is fucked up. But it gets even worse, because through this investigation through the Wall Street Journal, a lawyer for a former employee at Sledgehammer Games, an Activision-owned studio, alleged in their email that her client had been in 2016 and 2017 by her male supervisor after she had been pressured to consume too much alcohol in the office and at work events. The female employee reported the incidents to Sledgehammer's human resources department, but nothing happened, according to the email, which threatened a lawsuit against the company. Within months of receiving the email, said people familiar with the situation, Activision reached an out-of-court settlement with the woman, who also had reported one of the incidents to the police. Kotick didn't inform the company's board of directors about the alleged rapes or the settlement, said people with knowledge of the board. That is fucked up. Like, that actually, to me, deserves jail time. You covered up something that had been reported to the police. We're currently seeing Activision employees, current employees at all of these studios, demonstrate a walkout for your resignation. And it continues to get worse because through this investigation, they found that Dan Bunting, co-head of Activision's Treyarch studio, was accused by a female employee of sexually harassing her in 2017 after a night of drinking, according to people familiar with the incident. Activision Human Resources Department and other supervisors launched an internal investigation in 2019 and recommended that he be fired, but Bobby Kotick intervened to keep him. Dan Bunting, who led Treyarch through the production of several successful Call of Duty games, was given counseling and allowed to remain at the company. Dan Bunting didn't respond to the request for a comment about this situation from the Wall Street Journal, but an Activision spokeswoman said an outside investigation was conducted in 2020 after considering potential actions in light of that investigation. The company elected not to terminate Dan Bunting, but instead to impose other disciplinary measures. The craziest part about this is, after the Wall Street Journal reached out to Dan Bunting, he didn't comment, and then he literally just left the company. He just up and quit after the Journal asked about the incident. It's honestly so stomach-turning to hear about this because we've talked about Dan multiple times over the years. He was working on Call of Duty, I believe, since World at War at Treyarch, and he's worked on every single one of them all the way up until Cold War. So it's honestly so shocking to hear that. I did not expect that. I said it in my last video, and I'll say it again. It is incredibly upsetting to see the men and women who are just there to do their job. And it doesn't matter if it's the Call of Duty division or the King Mobile division or, you know, Blizzard, World of Warcraft, Diablo. It doesn't matter. Anything under Activision, the men and women who are there just to simply do a job, who aren't there to fuck around, who aren't there to do anything outside of just communicating with their coworkers, to see this stuff happen and to basically have the work that they did besmirched and disregarded and viewed as trash because of the things that other people do. And it reflects poorly on everyone at that point. And I think Bobby Kotick is handling this entire situation just horribly, absolutely horribly. And to make matters worse, he's doubling down. He doesn't intend to leave. He doesn't intend to resign. Take a look at this tone-deaf response that we've just gotten from Bobby Kotick himself. He says, "I want to talk with you today about our future and reiterate my conviction to create the most welcoming and inclusive workplace. Over the last few months, so many of you have generously and candidly shared your experiences and your insights about the type of company you want us to be. I've taken meaningful actions to improve our company and our culture, but there is more to do. To become the model workplace we all aspire to be, more change is required. But I'm also confident we will get there. There will, of course, be continued media attention about us and our industry over the next few months. In fact, there's an article today that paints an inaccurate and misleading view of our company, of me personally, and my leadership. I want to say two important things about this. First, we are incredibly fortunate to have the most talented people in our industry also committed to constant improvement, and I share this commitment. The second thing I want to say is that anyone who doubts my conviction to be the most welcoming, inclusive workplace doesn't really appreciate how important this is to me. Dude, you threatened to kill somebody. You threatened to destroy somebody's life, allegedly. Creativity and inspiration thrives best in a safe, welcoming, respectful environment. There is no substitute for that, and staying true to our values without exceptions is the best way to retain our talent and to attract new talent we need to achieve our great potential. As I have made clear, we are moving forward with a zero-tolerance policy for inappropriate behavior, and zero means zero. Any reprehensible conduct is simply unacceptable. Bobby, follow your own zero-tolerance policy and resign. Let's continue. We have a chance to further enhance our culture and be the example other companies will follow. And we are so incredibly fortunate. Connecting and engaging the world through joy and fun is a powerful mission. Accomplishing this in a welcoming, inclusive workplace ensures we will achieve our mission with excellence. Over the last few years, our industry has had an uncomfortable spotlight that's been illuminating opportunities for us to change. And we must all, including me, embrace this need for change so we can bring our very best selves to the very best place to work. Thank you for your commitment to a culture of respect, your appreciation for the unique talents we each possess, and for maintaining the very best environment for all of us to work. For that, I am truly grateful. Resign! The first piece of change needs to be with you. And although we have seen some change since everything's gone down in July, I think the biggest change still needs to happen, which is you leaving the company. While I was recording this commentary, the Wall Street Journal got a response from Activision's board of directors, and this is their statement. TLDR, they basically said Bobby makes him too much money and he's not going anywhere. So, yeah. That's not a reassuring thing at all. I mean, this is now tripling down. He does not plan to leave. I feel so incredibly bad for the employees that are there just to do their job. And then they have the guy at the top, the guy that's running the entire show, shitting on them from up above with such tone-deaf responses. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Of course, just like I said last time, if anything happens and there's any development in this entire situation, I'll make sure to have an update video right here on the channel. Thank you all so much for the continued support. If you guys see more Halo videos over the next couple of days, that's because I'm truly enjoying it right now, and I want to jump back in and talk a little bit more about it as we play. So thank you all. I'll catch you on the next video. Peace.